Kailangan mo rin ito kami sa Facebook. I'm so thankful kasi isa siya sa avid follower ng aming Facebook page. Then, nung nag-inquire siya sa akin na kumbaga dream niya na mapasali sa isang international budget, hindi siya nagdalawang salita. Sabi ko, sige, mag-tilap ka ng entry form and application. Then, doon ko nalaman na isa pala siyang teacher. And then, since pandemic nga, so parang nangyari sa aming budget virtual. So, all the candidates from different countries nagpadala ng video nila para sa kanilang talent, sa kanilang advocacy, at sa introduction nila. Kumbaga parang first time ito ni sumali sa isang budget, tapos international pa. Pero nakita ko yung effort niya kung paano niya ginampanan bilang Mrs. Tourism Northern Philippines. Kaya kumbaga nakita ko yung mga criteria na pwede siya gawing ambassador for education. Especially now, pandemic tayo, marami siyang gusto ko rin charity work through online. So, makikita niyo yung ipopost namin sa Facebook ng Mrs. Tourism, yung mga gagawin niyang charity work in terms of education. Yun. So, maraming salamat sa susunod, pwede na rin po kayo sumali. Di ba? Kasi po, ang budget po namin walang discrimination. Kahit anong kulay, wala kaming height requirements, wala kaming strict circumstances.
You have zero budget experience even during your single day. So basically, what made you decide to join?
I have several reasons why I joined this trip. First off, this was actually my childhood dream. So I wanted to be Miss Universe when I was young. And I actually had a blessing from my father. And it was written on a photograph. He said there, future Miss Universe. So I wanted to pursue that dream, even if he's not here with me anymore. He's in the States. And so I wanted to make him proud and reach that dream. Although it's not Miss Universe anymore, at least I was able to pursue that dream of becoming a beauty queen.
But you know, a crown will always be a crown, and a queen will always be a queen. And right now, you are already a queen of education for the rest of the year. So we mentioned that you'll be the ambassadress of education for 2021. So any plans during your reign?
Yes, I have a lot of things in mind. I intend to partner with the Department of Education in delivering workshops to different schools. First in San Jose del Monte. But if we are able to gather more sponsors, maybe we can go to other provinces. We intend to target mothers, women who are needing empowerment, so that we can strengthen them, and in turn, they will be able to empower the children, the family as well.
You know, Tony, during the pre-budget events of Mrs. Tourism Pageant 2021, I also hosted that. And one of the remarkable things that I noticed about you is during the talent competition, because I remember that some of the candidates from different parts of the country did their stage and did their elaborate talent in showcasing their talent. And you, what you did was, it's a monologue, if I can remember, and you did that inside the house. What's the reason behind that? Why did you make it inside your home?
Yes, actually, my son and I were exposed to a COVID-positive patient. Oh. That's why we were required to stay at home for 2 weeks for quarantine. Mm-hmm. And we are not allowed to transact with anyone, any photographers or makeup artists or, you know, for the video presentation. So what we did was, we just improvised. We actually used these are curtains for the stage. So, yeah.
It's a brown curtain, I remember.
It's really, I don't know, it's for, it showcases our resourcefulness. Uh-huh. Because even in the midst of scarcity, we were able to deliver.
And you know, having said that, I think you deserve a big round of applause. Because amidst all the challenges that we're facing and experiencing right now, yet you're able to push through with that kind of segment. And you know, a lot of people actually, well, during the time when I knew that instead of having live pageants here in the Philippines, you'll be doing it virtual. And at first, I thought that, it would be easier than the live pageant, but I proved myself wrong. Actually, that's why I commend the group of Megastar Production. It is actually harder than the live pageant. Really, even for the part of the host, ang hirap-hirap. But you know, we made it through. Now you already have your crown. So, ladies and gentlemen, once again, a big round of applause, please, for Mrs. Sony Iwato, our Mrs. Tourism Ambassador for Education 2021. And this one, I
left us when I was young. So I wasn't able to experience a complete family. So, and also my husband and I separated. So because of that, I want to prevent these kind of things happening in the future for others. So I want to prevent suicide. I want to decrease the level of suicide in the country, because I experienced that firsthand. I experienced depression way back, I think 2015. And because of that, I learned that you really have to rely on yourself. You have to have a strong faith in God for you to be able to pursue or to continue living and being an inspiration to many people.
My next question. Mom, as a teacher and as a single parent, what lessons have you learned from this event?
I've learned so much, but the first or the most important lesson is to have a very strong faith in God. Because if it's only me, I wouldn't be here anymore. I am gaining, or I am getting strength from God to continue, and I am always praying. I am always asking for His guidance, because I know that God will provide whatever challenges that you have, even if you are on the lowest point of your life. God is just one click or one sentence away. You just have to tell Him, God, I need your help. And He will surely come to help you.
Thank you, Mom, and congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mel Caparas. The next question will be coming from Mr. Molly Carioso of OPMB Worldwide.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Congratulations, Ms. Tony.
Thank you.
First of all, my first question is
many
personal. For you, what is meant to be?
And the po, sorry po.
For you, what is meant to be an educator?
An educator is bringing out the best in others. You have to hold their strengths and abilities so they can be the productive citizens that they were meant to be. You have to teach them not only how to be strong, but you also have to teach them service. Not only for themselves, but they have to give back to their communities. So being an educator is actually pouring yourself so that others will grow.
Wow.
Thank you, Bob.
Okay, a follow-up question. Given a chance to hold a position at the Department of Education, malay mo someday, di ba? Okay. What would be your long-term vision for the students, especially the youth and the children, to enable them to sustain better learning in spite of the crisis that we're experiencing now?
We need teachers who are dedicated. And as for me, my My highest goal is teacher 3, not even master, teacher, or principal. Why? Because I know that if you're in the front lines, you will be able to help many people. You will be able to help so many others in the community. You will be able to help others if you are in a higher position. But as for me, I want to do it, you know, in the front lines as a teacher 3.
So as a teacher, what has been the most impactful you have learned from your students and how did it affect your life?
I learned that a lot of students, or some of my students, are coming from broken families. I learned that there is a need. That there is a need to do something about it. That is why I pursued my degree, my master's degree in guidance, because I want to help children cope with their brokenness. Not only that, because I'm not targeting the children themselves, I'm also targeting the whole or the entire family. So I want to improve the family because we have to go back to the roots. We have to address the root of the problem. And I believe that children are not the problem, but it's their families. So I want to address that.
Yeah. How they are being raised, actually. No?
Yes, po.
Ayun. So recently, the Philippines was reported as one of the few countries that has not yet been doing a face-to-face classes. So if you are in the position of the Education Secretary Briones, no, would you also consider a face-to-face classes today, given this current situation?
If it's gonna be today, I think not yet, until everyone has been vaccinated, including the children, because we have to, first and foremost, think of the health and safety of our learners.
Wow. Last question na lang po.
Yes.
Based from your experience as a teacher, what are the challenges of your students that you think is now very common to all students in today's generation? And how does this challenge challenge you as a teacher?
I am very concerned about digital divide because a lot of families are not able to afford gadgets and being able to attend classes online. So we have to think of something so that no one will be left behind. I think that's the greatest challenge because we have to provide equal opportunities to everyone.